Hi, my name is Alex Ainbridge, and I'm a yoga teacher here in Baltimore. And I first started yoga about 7-8 years ago now, when I was attending Salisbury University, that's in the Eastern Shore of Maryland. And I took this winter semester course, thinking it would be an easy A, and it was yoga. And yeah, I realized how awesome yoga was. Like, in yoga class, a lot of people, we call it the yoga high, after it feels so good. And I felt it, and I was like, whoa, this is awesome. And I like kept doing it here and there. Probably about 4 years ago, I got really serious about it, because I love it so much. And I love like doing the practice, the physical practice, and just being able to see, like push myself past my limits, test my mind out, like pushing past fear. And that's what you do on the mat. But the thing is that we do these things on the mat because it translates to challenges that we come across in everyday life. So everything we discover on the mat enables us, strengthens us to just act better in the world, just be resilient no matter what comes our way. All right, so there are many, many health benefits of yoga. And I think it's really important to note the emphasis on breath. What makes yoga different than gymnastics is that it's a huge emphasis on the breath, and it's very important because you'll notice the benefits of the breath when you just take one deep breath to the base of your belly right now. Just try it. Just inhale and then exhale. And you'll notice maybe a relaxing sensation dwindling down. And that's just what happens is in everyday life, we'll be breathing really heavily into our chest. That's just what we do. We're not thinking about it. But that tells the body we're in panic mode. So to take a deep breath down to the base of the belly, well, that tells your body that everything is okay. And you'll relax and you're just able to handle day-to-day activities better. But it definitely increases blood flow just by using these deep breaths and moving the body into different postures will make you limber, stronger, and help with the bones, everything. Aging does the works. Something interesting about yoga, it was invented thousands and thousands of years ago in ancient India, where it was only for men back in the day. Specifically, 12-year-old boys, where there would be one guru, one boy. And that was it. That was a teacher-student relationship. There was no yoga classes. It was just one boy having to practice day in and day out under the tutelage of a guru who made him do a lot of stuff, and then he would become the next guru. And that was how the yoga lineage worked. Until it came to the West, the yogis decided the West needs yoga, which is true. And they knew that the lineage of the secret practice of guru to student would be changed when it came out here. So in here in the Western world, we're trying to find our way with the yoga community. It's different than what it was like in ancient India, but we're still trying to hold on to the same values and virtues of ancient yoga. So it's an interesting place we're at now. So yoga is not a religious thing at all. It has nothing to do with any religion. It is a simple practice of becoming mindful and connecting breath with the body. And there is a spiritual element to that, just in terms of meditation. They say yoga is a moving meditation, where we just become very aware of our bodies so in a very high way that it was actually developed to prepare the body for meditation. So this can suit any religious practice, be it Christian, Muslim. It's just a great way to connect with yourself and to connect with your faith. It's compatible with all. And they actually say that in the yoga scriptures. So, yeah. Why did I decide to join Peace Corps? So yeah, I served in the Peace Corps, and I lived in Ghana, West Africa, from 2012 to 2014, and it changed my life. It was an amazing experience, and I was already practicing yoga, and I was also a philosophy major in college, so I've always been thinking about the greater scheme of things. And I've always hated the prescribed ideal of you go to school, get a career, buy a house, have kids, and die. Like, I think there's so much more that life has to offer than just being a consumer. So after I graduated college, I decided to join the Peace Corps, and I eventually got in, and they told me I remember when I opened that packet, it was like, you're going to Ghana. I was like, whoa, Ghana. And then I was there, and it was amazing. And yeah, I continued my practice while I was there. I practiced by myself, and I had a girlfriend at the time. We would practice together, and I taught it to some kids. That was really awesome. Kids are just so fun to try the postures. They're actually way more flexible than us adults. So it's way easier for them to get into yoga poses than us. But yeah, having yoga while there definitely helped me through the stresses of feeling like an outsider. I think it's important to note that I never felt like an outsider because of the color of my skin until I lived in Ghana, and then people had like ideas about like the white man and stuff. Oh, it's because of colonialism, but they would say, oh, you're the white man, you have money and stuff like that. And I never experienced being like objectified or just feeling like an outsider because of my race. And so I came back here and I was like, whoa, I've been ignorant my whole life, and it changed the way I look at how things are here in America and just all over the world. And I'm so grateful for it. So you can find me on Instagram. My page is Bridger of Gaps. And you can also find me here at the Lift Studio at Mount Vernon. I teach Sundays at 10 a.m., Mondays 4:30 p.m., and Thursdays at 7 p.m. And yeah, see you soon. Oh yeah, and I have an upcoming project. I'm going to be doing a free yoga demo at the iHeart Health Expo, which is Saturday the 24th at Coppin State University. So be there or be square. Yeah, come out. I'm gonna demonstrate the hurdler posture, it's called. It's an arm balancing posture where you have to use a lot of core strength and balance simultaneously. And I would say it's one of my favorite postures to do because my yoga practice revolves around cultivating my own inner strength and harnessing that. It's something of mine that in everyday life it's really hard to portray because of the demands and feelings of others. And having a yoga practice on the yoga mat where I can just be with myself and harness my own inner strength is so powerful that I know I have it in everyday life. So I'll go ahead and do the posture. So inhale my right leg up, and then I'm gonna exhale, engage my navel, push my elbow right into my tricep, and then make a bookshelf with that. Engage my core, lift off, straighten the leg. Thanks for tuning in, guys. My name's Alex Ainbridge, and you can find me on IG at Bridger of Gaps. And don't forget, this Saturday the 24th, the free iHeart Health Expo will be at Coppin State University. And I'll be there, so come out. It'll be a good time.